السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه. الحمد لله الذي بيده مقاليد الفرج، والصلاة والسلام على النبي الأمي صاحب الجبين الأبلج، المبعوث رحمة للعالمين بأقوم دين وأعظم منهج، وعلى آله وأصحابه الذين نصروا الحق وكسروا الصنم. ثم أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم، من همزه ونفخه ونفثه. لقد جاءكم رسول من أنفسكم عزيز عليه ما عنتم حريص عليكم بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم. وقال سبحانه وتعالى في مقام آخر: وما أرسلناك إلا رحمة للعالمين. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, in this masjid of Old Hill Masjid, I would like to first thank you all for your attendance, and likewise to thank the brothers who are in charge of putting together this event. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from them. To begin, we must first remember that these majalis that we have, these sittings that we have, they are not like any normal majlis, any normal sitting that you may have. Rather, we should take something from these majalis. Not where you come, you sit, you enjoy, you leave, and nothing comes as a result after that. Rather, in Surah Az-Zumar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, فَبَشِّرْ عِبَادِ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَ أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ هَدَاهُمُ اللَّهُ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمْ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. That give glad tidings, فَبَشِّرْ عِبَادِ, give glad tidings, good news, congratulations to my slaves. All of the slaves of Allah, الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلِ, those who, when they hear any speech, when they hear any admonition, when they hear any maw'idha, any nasiha, any advice, فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَ, then they follow up the best of that. It does not go in one ear and out of the other ear. Rather, فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَ, they follow up the best of what they hear. They act upon the best of what they listen to. These people, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ هَدَاهُمُ اللَّهِ, they are the people whom Allah Dhul Jalal has guided. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمْ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ, and they are the people of lub, they are the people of understanding. Because when they hear any speech, then they follow it up and they act upon the best of what they listen to. And likewise, this majlis of ours in Sahih Muslim, Sayyidina Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he says that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَجْتَمَعَ قَوْمٌ فِي بَيْتٍ مِّن بُيُوتِ اللَّهِ, never do a people gather in a house from the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the masajid of buyutullah, or the houses belonging to Allah subhanahu. Never do people congregate and gather in a masjid from among the masajid, يَتْلُونَ كِتَابُ اللَّهِ, they recite the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَتَدَارَسُونَهُ بَيْنَهُمْ, and they study it among themselves. Never do people do this, illa, except نَزَلَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ السَّكِينَةُ وَغَشِيَتْهُمُ الرَّحْمَةُ وَحَفَّتْهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَذَكَرَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي مَنْ عِنْدَهُ. Never do people do this except that tranquility descends upon them from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the mercy of Allah bil Jalali wal Ikram envelops them, and the angels, they gather around them. وَذَكَرَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي مَنْ عِنْدَهُ, and Allah subhanahu, he mentions them with those who are with him. He mentions them by their names in front of the closest angels to him subhanahu wa ta'ala, as a means of boasting in front of them, in front of the angels, about these slaves of his who have gathered to recite the Quran, learn about the Quran, learn about deen, learn about sharia. And in Musnad Ahmad, the hadith of Sayyidina Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that Allah says about these people after they leave, قُومُوا مَغْفُورًا لَكُمْ, stand up and leave having all of your sins forgiven. هُمْ قَوْمٌ لَا يَشْقَى بِهِمْ جَلِيسُهُمْ, they are a people who have gathered and nobody among them is unfortunate, nobody among them is wretched. All of them, they will gain and they will reap and they will harvest the barakat and the fadail mentioned for those who congregate for talab al-ilm, for talab al-hadith. So coming up to my topic which I have been assigned, why should we follow, who knows what's the topic? Why should we follow? Anybody? Yeah. Why should we follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Why should we follow Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? So my reminder will just be split into a bit of a muqaddimah, a bit of an introduction, and then I will go on to the topic. So as an introduction to this topic, why should we follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Then first you must understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has created us among many creations. Among many khala'iq, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created human beings. And human beings were among the last that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created. Allah subhanahu created before mankind the angels, min nur, from light, He created the angels. And before mankind, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created the jinn. He created them from a smokeless fire, min nadin samum, from a smokeless fire. And then Allah subhanahu, after having created the angels, after having created the jinn, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created mankind. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created mankind, وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا. Man has been created weak. Man, human beings, are a very, very weak creation. Even though at times we may think we are invincible, we may think we are all powerful, we are on top of the world, Allah subhanahu sent you one small microbe which makes you ill for 1 week, then you realize how weak you are as a human being. As a creation, how da'if and how weak you are. Mankind is a very, very weak creation. Though we perceive ourselves to be all powerful, we are da'if, we are weak. And the weakest portion of this creation of ours, Allah subhanahu created our stature, created our physique, fi ahsan taqwim, in the best of all molds, best of all statures. But among our creation, our physical body, then the weakest part of our body, it is our heart. Our heart is the most weak. Hence why Imam Ahmad rahmahullah ta'ala, he records the hadith of Sayyidina Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiallahu ta'ala anhum. Alama al-Bani declared as Hassan, Imam Iraqi declared as Sahih. That our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّمَا سُمِّيَ الْقَلْبُ مِنْ تَقَلُّبِهِ. The heart has been termed, has been named as heart, قَلْب مِنْ تَقَلُّبِهِ, because of its changing nature, because of how frequent it alters and it changes. Our hearts are always prone to changing and to altering and to quivering, and to always, our hearts are hardly thabit, our hearts are hardly steadfast, rather they are always changing, our hearts are always changing. And we see this with the latest trends that come, the latest fashion and the trend. Then, as if we are a, as if human beings are a waraqa fil hawa, as if we are a leaf floating in the wind. Whichever way the wind blows, then the leaf will fly that way. That's how human beings we are. That's how our hearts are. That they will change and they will alter according to whatever circumstances around them. Hence why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As radiallahu anhu, as a Muslim, he said that the most frequent dua of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was, Allahumma ya muqallib al-qulub thabbit qalbi ala deenik, or ya musarrif al-qulub sarrif qalbi ila ta'atik. O you who is the changer of hearts, O you who is the alterer of the hearts, make my heart steadfast upon your deen, upon your obedience. O Allah, make my heart steadfast, because our hearts are always quivering, they are always changing. Hence why when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the beginning of Surah Ali Imran, that هو الذي أنزل عليك الكتاب منه آيات محكمات هن أم الكتاب وأخر متشابهات. In the Quran there are muhkam ayat, there are clear-cut evident ayat, and there are ambiguous ayat. Then Allah mentions the dua of Ulul Albab, the people of understanding. Their dua is Rabbana la tuzigh qulubana ba'da idh hadaytana. Oh our Lord, do not deviate, do not misguide our hearts. Rabbana la tuzigh qulubana. Do not misguide, do not deviate our hearts after they have been guided. Because the hearts are very prone to being misguided, to changing and to altering. This is the weakest part of a human being, is their heart. And how can a person's heart become firm? How can a person's heart not quiver and not change with the latest fad and the latest style and the latest trend that comes about? In Surah Hud, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentions that why Allah subhanahu mentions the various stories of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Each one of them we described to you, we told you their stories of my Habib sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam. Ma nuthabbitu bihi fu'adak. That by which your heart will remain firm. By listening and by hearing the struggles and the stories of the prophets of old alayhi salatu wasalam, that is what will bring about, ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the firmness of your heart. Ma nuthabbitu bihi fu'adak. By hearing of the struggles and the sacrifices of the prophets alayhi salatu wasalam. If this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is why we gave you the stories of the prophets, in order that your heart may become firm, man thabbitu bihi fu'adak. Then how about our hearts when we learn about our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who he is ashraful mursaleen, who he is sayyidul mursaleen, imamul mursaleen. He is the leader of all of the prophets alayhi wa salatu wa salam. Will our hearts not become steadfast by studying his seerah alayhi salatu wa salam, by learning about him, about his shama'il, his sifat, his characteristics, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how he was, and the learning about the importance of his ita'a, his obedience, and of obeying him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Surely by this a person's heart will become firm and a person's heart will become steadfast. So this is a great reason why should we follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is one of the routes, one of the ways by which a person can ensure their heart is firm upon the truth. Ensure their heart is steadfast upon the truth by following, by learning about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Hence why we should learn about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Likewise, Allah bin Jalali wa Ikram, everybody knows he has commanded us to follow him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا. Suratul Ahzab, and we'll come back to this ayah. There is for you in the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the perfect example to follow. أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا. For which person? لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهِ. For the one who has hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ. And has hope in Yawm al-Qiyamah, وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. And he remembers Allah much. For these people who have hope in the Akhirah, hope in the meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they are plenty make dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for these believers, for them, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا. For them you have a great, a perfect example to follow in Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in all aspects of his life. Whatever aspect of life, he is the perfect role model alayhi salatu wasalam. Hence why you should follow him. Why? Because he is the only human being. The only human being whom ita'a to him. What does ita'a mean? Anybody know? To be obedient. He is the only human being to whom obedience is غير مشروط. Is غير مشروط. meaning it is unconditional, unstipulated. It is unconditional obedience to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Otherwise, everybody else, every other human being, then obedience to them is not غَيْرُ مَشْرُوطٍ, rather it is مَشْرُوط. It is conditional. That obedience is in accordance to the obedience to Allah and to His Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with the Messenger of Allah, then there is no question of مَشْرُوط or غَيْرُ مَشْرُوط, of being conditional obedience or unconditional obedience. To the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ita'a and obedience and following and copying and imitating is only and only غير مشروط, unconditional. Everybody else, then a question mark can be put to them. Why? Except for the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Imam al-Madina, Imam Dar al-Hijra, Imam Malik rahmahullah ta'ala. He has his famous statement that كُلٌّ يُؤْخَذُ مِنْ قَوْلِهِ وَيُرَدُّ, every single human being, his statement can be accepted or his statement can be rejected. Both possibilities are there, both ihtimalat are there. Whether his statement, his action is accepted or whether it is rejected. إِلَّا صَاحِبُ هَذَا الْقَبْرِ, except for the inhabitant of this grave, and he was sat next to the grave of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Apart from him, everybody else, then the statement can be accepted or the statement can be rejected. Why? Because this Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the only human being whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, لِيَغْفِرَ لَكَ اللَّهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ. Whatever is in the past, whatever is in the future, from your mistakes, then all of that has been forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What we say is that He is ma'asum anil khata. He is free from error. Free from error, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it's our belief, our aqeedah, that lamma dufina, when He was buried, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, دفنت العصمة معه, then infallibility was buried with him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he was buried in his grave in the house of Sayyida al-Mu'mineen Tayyiba Tahira Sayyida Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, that buried with him was infallibility. Buried with him was the fact that nobody can, that everybody will be mistaken after him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As he said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, حديث سيدنا أنس رضي الله تعالى عن سنة بن ماجه وغيره, he said, كل بني آدم خطاء. All of Banu Adam, they will make errors. They will fall into error. They will make mistakes. وخير الخطائين التوابون. And the best of those who have fallen into error are those who turn back to Allah. Those who they repent for that wrong that they have committed. Every human being, كل بني آدم خطاء. But our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لِيَغْفِرَ لَكَ اللَّهُ مَا تَقَدَّمُ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأَخَّرِ. He is معصوم عن الخطاء عليه الصلاة والسلام. Free from error, free from mistake, infallible in all regards. And if he were to be mistaken in something, then immediately Allah would send Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi الصلاة والسلام. This is the sha'an, this is the position of our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul, a very infamous person, notorious person. Does anybody know who this person was? Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul. He was, yes sir.
Is this the leader of the hypocrites?
Ahsant. He was the leader. Not just any normal munafiq, any one of the mill hypocrite. He was the chieftain and the leader of the munafiqeen, Ra'isul Munafiqeen. His name was Abdullah ibn Ubay. His son, Abdullah, his name was the same as the name of his father, Abdullah ibn Abdullah ibn Ubay. When his father died, the hypocrite, chieftain, and his hypocrisy was a known hypocrisy, manifest, evident, Nobody was in doubt in regards to the hypocrisy and the nifaq of Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul. When he died, then his son Abdullah was a righteous Sahabi, Abdullah ibn Abdullah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, asking to pray the janazah of his father, who was a munafiq, asking for tabarruk from the qamis, the shirt of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to place in the grave of his father. And when he went, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he went, and he offered the janazah of Abdullah ibn Ubay. Then after this, immediately, share the rank of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah sent Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Revelation, وَلَا تُصَلِّ عَلَىٰ أَحَدٍ مِّنْهُمْ مَاتَ أَبَدًا وَلَا تَقُمْ عَلَىٰ قَبْرِهِ. Any one of these munafiqeen, O my Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, never offer their janazah prayer for them, and never ever stand at their grave asking for forgiveness. This was the position of our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that if he was to make an error in anything, then immediately Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would send Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi wa sallam for rectification. This is not for anybody beside our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Jibreel would come to them and rectify them of their error, clarify the mistake. This was only our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why to follow him? Because this is his rank. This is his status, that were he to make a misjudgment, then immediately revelation would correct him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and make clear the truth. For anybody else, this is not the case. This is not the case. Hence why our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he held the rank that he had of isma, of infallibility. Sayyidina Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Jabir ibn Abdullah ibn Amr ibn Haram al-Ansari radiallahu ta'ala anhu. In Sunan al-Darimi, he says that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Low," it's a very important hadith, he said, "Low bada lakum Musa." Wa Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wa sallam. All of us are aware who Sayyidina Musa was. Yeah? Wa Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wa sallam to appear to you once more. "Low bada lakum Musa." فَاتَّبَعْتُمُونَ. And you followed him, Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wa sallam, who is Kalimullah. وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهُ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا. But Allah subhanahu spoke directly to Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wa sallam. Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wa sallam, whom Allah subhanahu gave him the Torah min ghayri wasit, without any intermediary, directly Allah subhanahu gave the Torah to Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wa sallam. This Musa, لو بدا له موسى, where Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wa sallam to come appear to you once more. فاتبعتمو, and you followed him. وتركتموني, and you abandoned me, you left me, you left me. لضللتم عن سواء السبيل, you would be misguided from the correct path. If Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wa sallam was to appear, and we follow Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, who is from Ulul Azmi min al-Rusul, the greatest of the messengers, were we to follow him and abandon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, leave, forsake the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then we would be misguided away from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our mashayikh, they say, how then, if somebody was to follow, this is for a Nabi, huh? This is for a Rasul, Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. How then, if somebody is to follow somebody from inside the Ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, below than any Nabi, any human being, any Imam, Peer, Mufti, Sheikh, somebody was to follow him in opposition to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, would that not be misguidance? Would that not be going astray? This is the Sha'an of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he is the one whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about him, that وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ. Never does he speak alayhi salatu wa sallam out of his own wishes, out of his own desire, rather it is only revelation which is inspired to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Whatever he says, however he says, that is revelation sent from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Likewise, what is similar to this is in Sunan of Imam Abu Dawood rahmahullah ta'ala, Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Amr ibn Aas رضي الله تعالى عنهما. He says that I was sitting with the Quraysh. فنهتني قريش. They forbade. كنت أكتب كل ما سمعت من الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. I used to write everything I heard from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Every single hadith of his, every single riwayah, every single thing that escaped his lips, I would document and I would write down. فنهتني قريش. And Quraysh, they stopped me. They rebuked me. They said that وهو بشر يتكلم في الغضب والرضا. He's a human being. He speaks in anger. He speaks in pleasure. Ask and write. Take permission and write. Document his hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I complained to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he said, "Uktub ya Abd Allah." فوالذي نفسي بيده ما يخرج منه إلا الحق. Write, O Abdullah. For nothing escapes my lips, nothing leaves my mouth, except that it is the haqq, except that it is the truth from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the maqam of our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. Why follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Because everything that escapes his lips, it is the haqq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is the truth. Kitab al-Sunnah, the book of Allah, and the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, this is a da'wah of haqq, da'wah of truth. وَمَاذَا بَعْدَ الْحَقِّ إِلَّا الضَّلَالُ فَأَنَّا تُصْرَفُونَ. What is there beyond the truth except for misguidance? How it is that you are averted away. فَمَاذَا بَعْدَ الْحَقِّ إِلَّا الضَّلَالُ. What is there apart from, away from, aside from the truth, except that which is deviance, and except that which is misguidance. Why follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam? In Surah Ali Imran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed in what is called as Ayatul Mihna. Ayatul Mihna, the ayah of examination, or the ayah of testing, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي. Say to them, O my Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if truly you love Allah subhanahu, if your claim is that you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَاتَّبِعُونِي, then follow me, follow my way, follow my sunnah, follow my path, فَاتَّبِعُونِي, يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will love you. وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. And He will forgive you of your sins. Wallahu ghafoor rahim. Allah is the all forgiving, the ever merciful. If we compare this with Sayyidina Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, compare this ayah of Surah Ali Imran with the beginning of Surah Nuh. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. And He will forgive you of your sins. In Surah Nuh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ أَنْ أَنذِرْ قَوْمَكَ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ إِنِّي لَكُمْ نَذِيرٌ مُبِينٌ أَنْ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَاتَّقُوهُ وَأَطِيعُونِ. He was sent to tell his people, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of Allah, وَأَطِيعُونَ, and obey me. What's the next ayah? يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ مِنْ ذُنُوبِكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will forgive you min dhunubi. Daqiq nukta, very daqiq nukta. That here in Surah Ali Imran, there's no min. وَلِنْ كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. In Surah Nuh, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُونِي يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ مِنْ ذُنُوبِكُمْ. This little two-letter word of min makes a world of difference. In Surah Ali Imran, Allah is saying, فَاتَّبِعُونِي, follow me, يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ. Allah, He will love you, وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. He will forgive you of all of your sins. وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورُ رَحِيمٌ. And in Surah Nuh, He will forgive you, وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ مِنْ ذُنُوبِكُمْ. مِنْ تَبْعِيضِيَّة, the min of تَبْعِيض. He will forgive you of some of your sins. He will forgive you of a portion of your sins. أو إطاعة أو نبي أن إطاعة of the أنبياء سابقين is إطاعة الاتباع of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is a means of forgiveness of all of the sins. However many sins have been accumulated, but with the previous messengers, following them, إطاعة to them, obedience to them, following their way, their path, was a means of forgiveness of a portion of their sins. يغفر لكم من ذنوبكم ويؤخركم إلى أجل مسمى إن أجل الله إذا جاء لا يؤخر لو كنتم تعلمون. So this is why to follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because there is a means, a cause of a person's sins having been forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not a portion, not a few, not a little, but وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. All of your sins will be forgiven as a cause of your ittiba, as a cause of your following of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. That is the virtue of Allah which He distributes to whoever He wishes. This is the fadilah of this ummah. This is the virtue of this ummah. This ummah that we are part of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Likewise, it is important to follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam in all affairs of life, because he is, as we mentioned before, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. He is the best, the perfect example to follow in all areas of life. As a father, he is the best example to follow. As a husband, he is the best example to follow. As a general, he is the best example to follow. As somebody who is humble, he is the best example to follow. In all areas of life, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. As a father, when his daughter, Sayyidah Aisha narrated, his daughter Sayyidah Fatima Zahra radiallahu ta'ala anha, when she would enter upon him, then he would stand up, kiss her on her forehead, and make her sit where he was sitting sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. As a husband and treatment of a person's wife, then he is the best example to follow sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. خَيْرُكُمْ خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِهِ وَأَنَا خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِي. The best of you who is the best to their wives, I am the one who is the best to my. And the examples are so many, how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he had the best conduct with his wives radiallahu ta'ala anhunna. He is the best example as somebody who has courage. Sayyidina Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu in Sahih Bukhari, he says that when there was a scary sound that came in Medina, perhaps an enemy had launched their attack, so there was some frightening sound in Medina, and all of us were worried, what is going to happen? And after having gathered our courage together, and we went out, we find the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was already there on his animal without any saddle, already there saying, nothing is here, nothing is wrong, I have already checked, nothing is here. As someone who was courageous, he was the best example sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As somebody who was humble, إِنَّمَا أَكُلُ كَمَا يَأْكُلُ الْعَبْدُ وَأَجْلِسُ كَمَا يَجْلِسُ الْعَبْدُ. I eat the way a slave eats, I sit the way a slave sits sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In humility, humbleness, he was the best example sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In every aspect of life, whichever role you wish to bring, then our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was the best example to follow. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. Why? Follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I hope I shed a little bit of light on this topic, why we should follow Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what are some of the fadail, some of the virtues, and some of the benefits of following the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. هذا ما عندي والله تعالى أعلم وأعلم بالصواب علم وأتم. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.